good?
Very good. You know, I was here 40 years ago, and I lived just over at that
hotel. 40.
40.
40.
40.
That's when I was born.
Right? Yeah. Then I'm a bit ahead of you.
40. Wow. È un vino rosso per la signora. Solo un vino rosso.
Hello. How are you?
Good in there.
So you were in that hotel?
Hotel Sole.
Ah, Sole, okay.
It's changed a lot inside. Now we are staying at the Pantheon. 78, it was the second. I remember it vividly.
I can imagine. I don't remember that.
Sorry, not to eavesdrop, but I was. How has Rome changed since you've been here?
Not in Rome. Well, of course, there's more traffic.
More police.
It's more rapid.
Yeah, more police and more people with machine guns.
Yes, I noticed that. It was quite shocking.
And you were not allowed to take pictures of it. We would take a picture. He said, no.
At that time, we could enter the St. Peter Basilica unattached.
No line. Okay.
No line.
Just
now walk. It's long line.
Up the front.
Where do you come from in the U.S.?
I'm actually Canadian.
Canadian?
Yeah, but I live in Glasgow.
Glasgow?
Yeah.
Oh, what nice.
Yeah, no, beautiful country.
Yeah.
And, I decided to come to Rome a few days ago for Christmas.
Is it your first time?
Yes, actually I got in this morning at 8. And I walked into the Pantheon, I'm like,
this is a good place.
I'm in awe. Like, you see it so much, you grow up learning about it, but the scale.
Yes.
You know, I thought everything was like, you know, maybe two-thirds the scale. Like, the scale is unbelievable, yeah. Really quite something.
And the Peter's Palace were down there.
Pardon?
The Peter's
Palace. Yes. Yeah, actually, I just got a call. I got a ticket to Midnight Mass.
Did you really? How nice.
Yes.
You are lucky.
Yeah, priest just, he said he got a ticket. He's going to meet me at the square tomorrow. Just
nice.
Yeah, it's... my mom and my babas are, they're like, oh, you're going to Mass at St. Peter's for Midnight Mass?
Yeah. That is
awesome. Yeah, it'll be beautiful.
Do you know the dome? It's still one of the largest in the world.
Thank you.
Oh, great. It's very nice. I downloaded, there's a travel writer named Rick Stevies, and he does a series of podcasts with maps, so I've downloaded all of them so I don't have to get an audio guide, because I do quite like audio guides. It gives you all the history and...
This is a bright
place. I like cities to wander and get lost in. I thought Barcelona was magical, but, you know, within an hour and a half, I was like, no comparison. Yeah, no comparison.
Okay.
more like the trailer. No, I have
more.
Of course you may.
Please, sir.
Ah. I'm Norwegian, but I live in Denmark for many years.
Not yet, but I have. I traveled last year in Spain, and I ended up traveling with a young man who was from Denmark. And yeah. I was going to visit him for Christmas, but now I'll go in the spring. Yeah, well, it's so nice to go someplace where someone can show you around.
Yeah.
I mean, I do like the touristy, like, I like this kind of touristy thing, but I'd much rather.
Go yourself, yeah.
Yeah.
We went to see the Pantheon Museum today.
Oh, yes.
Very, very early. We were at St. Peter's at 7 o'clock this morning.
Oh, my.
And there was no line.
Yesterday we was there 2 in the afternoon.
Yeah.
And there was a kilometer line. Yeah. We didn't want to wait.
That was early.
I already bought my ticket. I booked it online. I paid a little, an extra fee. Because I don't like lines. Yeah, so I booked.
So then you can go right in when you have it.
I can go right in. I don't need to wait.
No, that's good.
The only other one I booked was, well, because you have to the Via Borghese.
Oh, yeah.
When we had finished visiting the church, we wanted to visit the museum.
It's complex. It's a city state. I think you have to go out. Yeah.
You go around the whole thing. Yeah. And then when you come out in the church again. So that's good.
Yeah, well that's why I'm gonna split St. Peter's up.
Yeah.
I'll do St. Peter's on Rotunda for Mass, and then the Vatican on a couple days later.
Yeah.
What is your favorite thing to do in Rome? So I'm a first time Roman holiday girl.
Well, we went to see the Trevi Fountain.
Ah, yes.
It's 7 minutes that way.
There's people everywhere.
You
can hardly get
to the thing. As many as there is only on this square right now.
I have a path to do on Christmas Day because everything's shut down, and the Trevi Fountain is sort of the major.
We were here yesterday. We had this opera singer standing right over there.
He sang right there.
He sang as well as Pavarotti.
Yeah.
What a charming experience.
It was so fantastic. We went by the St. Angelo this morning. There was musicians there who were just on their way. Today it was a woman who built by Laika who was singing.
Very interesting.
Yesterday there was two Italians and one played a fantastic guitar and the other one played the violin.
The acoustics, you know, they're so special.
Well, they had amplifiers, of course, but still it was blown away.